Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with the new Hibernate tip. Today I will explain the difference between the join column and primary key join column annotations and which one you should use in your code. But before we begin, if this is your first time here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Himanshu asked today's question on one of the videos on this channel, and he wanted to know what's the difference between the join column and primary key join column annotation. Also, should we use primary key join column or join column? The join column and the primary key join column annotations might seem very similar, but they are used in two different contexts. You can use the join column annotation to map the foreign key column of a managed association. The primary key join column specifies the mapping of the foreign key column of a secondary table or the foreign key column in an inheritance mapping that uses the joint strategy. So the annotation you need to use depends on the context in which you want to customize the mapping of the foreign key column. Let's have a look at example mappings for both annotations in the IDE. When you add the join column annotation to your association mapping, you can define the name of the foreign key column that represents your association in the table model. I use it here to tell Hibernate it shall use the column book underscore key as the foreign key column of the many-to-one association. When you activate the logging of SQL statements and fetch a review entity from the database, you can see that Hibernate uses the book key column to map the association. When you use the inheritance mapping strategy joined, all columns mapped by the superclass get mapped to one database table, and the specific attributes of a subclass get mapped to a different table. Hibernate has to join these two tables whenever you use the subclass. The primary key columns of each table are then used as the join columns. You can see the superclass of such an inheritance hierarchy here. By default, Hibernate expects that the primary key columns of both tables have the same name. If that's not the case, you can annotate your subclass with a primary key join column annotation. As you can see in the log message, Hibernate maps the primary key of the book table to the book ID column. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!